Africa and the world. Welcome back to this week's episode of Wonders, where we discuss wonderful, incredible stories that actually happen. Now, this week's episode is very exciting as it has caused the whole social media to shake like 10. Now, a Gabonese man marries four women at the same time in a grand wedding ceremony. Now, this man is called Mesmin Abesole. His guy name or his nickname is Kita Di Bonagari. Now, he married these people at Libreville, Gabon. That is the capital of Gabon. Now, one may ask that, is this the first time something like that has happened? The answer is no. Because about 2-3 years ago, a South African businessman also married four women in almost the same conjugal or grand style in South Africa. And this is serious news on social media. Now, before we go into the gist of this evening's Wonders program, we want to take a little religious preamble. But first of all, what is polygamy? Polygamy is a practice or custom of having more than one wife or one husband. Now, if you have more than one wife, we call it polygyny. If you have more than one husband, we call it polyandry. But for the purposes of this evening's Wonders program, we are talking about polygyny. Now, although the Old Testament describes numerous examples of polygamy, for that matter, polygyny among devotees to God, most Christian groups have historically rejected the practice of polygamy and have upheld monogamy as normative or normal or as what is acceptable by God. That notwithstanding, some Christian groups in different periods have practiced or currently do practice polygamy. Some Christians actively debate whether the New Testament or the Christian ethics allows or forbids polygamy as of now, and there are several Christian views on the Old Covenant. This debate focuses almost exclusively on polygyny. Now, Genesis chapter 2, verse 24, the Bible says that therefore a man shall leave his wife, leave his father and his mother, and hold fast or cling to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Now, let's take a dive into a Jewish background. Despite these nuances to the biblical perspective on polygamy, or for that matter, polygyny, many important figures in the Bible have had more than one wife, and we will consider these instances. Let's consider the instances of Esau, Jacob's brother in the Bible, Esau. Now, Genesis chapter 26, verse 34, and Genesis chapter 28, verses 6 to 9. That is for Esau. And then Jacob, Genesis chapter 29, verses 15 to 28. Then we have Elkanah, 1 Samuel chapter 1, verses 1 to 8. And then David, 1 Samuel 25, 39 to 44. Then 2 Samuel chapter 3, verses 2 to 5. And then 2 Samuel chapter 5, 13 to 16. And then the great Solomon. 1 Kings chapter 11, verses 1 to 3. Now, multiple marriage was considered a realistic alternative in the case of famine, widowhood, of female infertility, like in the practice of levirate marriage, wherein a man was required to marry and support his deceased brother's widow, as mandated by Deuteronomy chapter 25, verses 5 to 10. Despite its prevalence in the Hebrew Bible, scholars do not believe that polygyny was commonly practiced in the Bible, biblical era, because it required a significant amount of wealth. Now, in those days, you required to be rich, wealthy enough to be able to have more than one wife, because there were a lot of demands, or it required a lot. Now, let's zoom in onto this evening's or this week's Wonders episode 3. Gabonese man marries 4 women at the same time in a grand wedding. As I said, the businessman is called Mesmin Abesoli, popularly called Keta Di Bonageri. Now, this marriage took place in Libreville on Saturday, 31st July 2021, this year. Now, one may ask that, who are these wives? Now, we have Madeleine Nguema, Preska Nguema, Nicole Mbungu. Then, the fourth one is Karen Silvana Aboget. Now, this grand ceremony or marital event was officiated by the fourth deputy mayor of Gabonese capital, Libreville, called Edward Karim Nziengwi. Now, a lot of social media users see all this as watching a movie, but truly, it actually happened. Just the same way, about a few years ago in South Africa, a businessman married 4 women, married 4 brides at the same time. Now, this Mesmin gentleman we are talking about has already got 32 children, and his wife he married in 2008 is so happy about the whole spectacle the husband is displaying that she says she's happy, she's joyous, and she's welcoming her rivals without any qualms. Now, this actual wife of his, or first wife of his, is called Christel Abesolu. Christel Abesolu. Now, what is bothering the mind of a lot of social media users is, how is this man's wedding night going to look like? How are his conjugal activities, viewers, more functioning? How are the conjugal activities going to look like? But hey, there's even Islam where marriage to 4 women is allowed. But that is when you have money. You are responsible, you are wealthy enough to be able to take good care of them. So if they're able to take... at least 2 to 4 wives, I believe, or a lot of people also believe that this gentleman, this Gabonese, can also take good care of these 4 wives. Now, along the line in this production, we'll show pictures of the wedding ceremony and a little footage of the ceremony. Now, let's zoom in onto this issue of polygyny using this Gabonese marital spectacle as a yardstick. Now, the monogamy of the Roman Empire was a cause of two exemplary notes in the writings of Josephus, describing how the polygamous marriages of Herod, King Herod the Great, were permitted under the Jewish custom. Polygamy was a rare exception in post-exilic Israel. That is, after Israel was out of exile, the practice began to be criticized and declined during the intertestamental period, but there is some extant evidence of polygamy being practiced in the New Testament period. What you are talking about is periods between the Old Testament and the New Testament. Now, when you look at the Dead Sea Scrolls, it shows that several smaller Jewish sects forbid polygamy before and during the time of Jesus. When you look at the Temple Scroll too, 11 QT LV II 17 to 18, it seems to also prohibit polygamy. Now, let's consider what goes through the mind of polygamous men. A typical example of a polygamous man like this Gabonese, he who is being polygynous, what is going through his mind, or what is going through the mind of polygamous people? Now, what viewers must know is that in the mind of polygamists, their polygamists do not dispute that in marriage two shall be one flesh. They don't dispute that. They only disagree with the idea that a married man can only be one flesh with one woman. Assuming the man is married, the fact that a man can even be one flesh with a harlot apparently does not negate his being one flesh with his wife. Furthermore, if a man is married, he and his wife are one flesh. To add another wife would mean that the new wife becomes one flesh, in quotes, with a man and his current wife. Now, one scholar called Gill argues that polygamists, in disagreeing with the idea that a married man can only be one flesh with one woman, are in fact disagreeing with Apostle Paul, who makes it clear in the New Testament that in the Christian covenant, the man who already has one wife cannot add another wife because his body belongs to the one wife and is no longer his. If this said man adds another wife, then that woman is coveting another woman's husband. In the Christian covenant, a woman shall not covet another woman's husband, just like in the Mosaic or Moses' covenant, A man shall not covet another man's wife. So, in effect, it is talking about morality. That if you have your wife, stick to your wife. Do not have another wife or something like that. That is what this is saying. Now, many critics of polygamy also point to the Apostle Paul's epistles that state that church officials, Church of Pentecost, Assemblies of God, and all that respectable church positions should be above reproach, and that they should be husband of but one wife. And that is in 1 Timothy chapter 3 and in Titus 3. Now, hermeneutically, the Greek phrase mias gunaikos andra is an unusual Greek construction capable of being translated in multiple ways, including but not limited to one wife man. So that is to say that that is to add on to what Apostle Paul is saying, that you must be a one wife man. You understand that you should be monogynous in order to take a church position, and that prohibits plural marriage. Now, the question that is going to people's minds is, this man has already got it, which is also going through people's minds, apart from the conjugal activities, is this man has already got 32 children. A football team is made up of 11 players. So in actual fact, it means that with these four wives, if he marry, he gives birth to a bit more, he can be having something like 33 to 44 children. And that means that he can have about four teams. That is on a lighter note. Now, thank you all for being there for Dundee One TV and always watching our videos. Now, if you have been watching our videos but have not been liking or commenting, now let's take this opportunity that in the live comment, let's comment, let's contribute. And after the live premiering, you can also comment at the main comment site. Now, remember to subscribe. Look at the lower right hand corner. Click on the red subscribe. Click on the bell. Click on all that you are subscribed so that anytime we upload a video, you'll be one of the first YouTube will automatically alert. And then when you are alerted, try and then watch from beginning to the end, like or dislike based upon certain aspects of the content you are amazed at or you are not happy with. And also, what is important to us is share on all social media outlets available to you, Facebook groups, WhatsApp groups, and all social media outlets available to you. Now tell a friend, tell another friend, tell another relative about Dondu One TV. There are also other channels of ours, sister channels of ours. We have Dondu One O2 Plus TV, Dondu One Travels Plus TV, Dr. Ibrahim Sigo TV. Now let's continue to support Dondu One TV to grow and keep on growing. Now we have about 4,220 plus subscribers and counting. We thank you all for continuing to be there for us. Thank you so much, and then spread the news. Continue to subscribe. Continue to subscribe. We should hit about 10,000 subscribers by the end of the year. Continue to be there for us. We thank you so much, and bye bye.